Okay, in this example, you just need to simplify each of the following algebraic expression. So what I mean here, you just write, if you see here, the first one, okay, let's say x plus 2y multiplied by x plus 2y. If you see here, how many times we repeat the same expression?
2.
So the answer is like, simply like this. You just need to write as x plus 2y to the power of 2. Or I can say as x plus 2y square. Okay? When we see how many times it is repeated, so put it as the power. Okay, letakkan dia sebagai kuasa. Second, mn. So if you see here how many times we repeated mn. So you put in the bracket. Okay, mn to the power of 4. But if you write like this, mn to the power of 4, this is wrong. Why this is wrong? Because only n with the power of 4. Okay, kalau waktu dia macam ni, hanya n saja kuasa 4. Sedangkan m dengan n tu dua-duanya kuasa 4. That's why we need to put in bracket. Another answer you can also give like this, okay? M to the power of 4, n to the power of 4. This is correct. Understand?
Yes.
Okay, but this time I want you to write in this form. M, n in bracket to the power of 4. Okay, next. Reverse from what you did before. Terbalik pada awak yang buat tadi. Tadi kita buat apa? Kalau ada ulang, berulang, kita hanya buat kuasa kan? Okay, sekarang ni dia tulis 2p minus 3q to the power of 3. So, means that you need to write this expression 3 times. So, here. In bracket, 2p minus 3q multiply 2p minus 3q and another one. Okay, just write like that. Second, FG. Okay, this one no need to put bracket. Still okay, okay. Multiply by FG multiply by. Okay, for fifth time. Okay, tulis dia sebanyak 5 kali. Sebab dia berulang. Okay, dia terbalik pada yang tadi lah. Okay, simple je. This time we want to multiply 3m square n. N multi 3m square n multiply by 3m n to the power of 3. So, okay, from here you should understand what is the meaning of m square. Apa yang dimaksudkan dengan m kuasa 2? We have m for 2 times. What is the meaning of n to the power of 3? And separate every terms one by one. Okay, what I mean is like this, eh? Okay. Okay, right now, you separate one by one. Okay, for 3m to the m square, and you can write as 3 multiply by m multiply by m multiply by n. Can you see? Okay, next, for the second terms. Okay, also do the same thing. Okay, this time I will use the different color. Multiply by 3 multiply by m multiply by
n multiply by n multiply by n.
Okay, right now, if you see here, which one can we solve? Okay, first, you see the coefficient or the number. Awak tengok ni nombor dulu. 3 multiply by 3, what is the value?
9.
Next, you see how many m we have here?
3.
1, 2, so means that m to the power of
3.
How many n we have?
4.
1, 2, 3 and 4. So n to the power of
4.
Can you understand?
Yes.
Okay, this is what you what is written in your textbook. Okay, another thing you can also do like this. Cara lain, another method you can also do like this. But actually this method you will learn in form 3. But never mind, I just show to you. Okay, first you see the coefficient. Awak tengok pada coefficient dulu, darab. 3 multiply by 3 equal to? Okay, you can do like this, okay? 3 multiply by 3 followed by m to the power of 2 and multiply by m n to the power of 3. Can you see? Cikgu ambil coefficient tu buat keluar semua. Lepas tu kita salin yang dia punya variable. Nampak? Okay, next. Okay, as what you did, as what we did before, 3 multiply by 3? 9. Okay, now you see here, here we have m. Berapa m ada?
2.
Sini ada berapa lagi m?
1.
Ha, tambah 2 tambah 1 berapa?
3.
Ha, that's why m equal to 3. Okay, next, and we have 1 and here we have another 3. So 1 plus 3?
4.
Okay, n equal to 4. Same answer. Okay, boleh buat mana-mana kaedah. Second example. So here, let's say if we did this step, okay, kita buat macam ni. Okay, now we can write as 6 multiply by P multiply by P multiply by Q
multiply by Q.
Okay, next. What is the meaning of negative Q up? Apakah yang dimasukkan dengan negative Q up? Negatif tu kita boleh anggap sebagai negative 1, okay? Negative 1. Okay, coefficient ni 1 kat situ. Kita tak tulis kan, biasa 1. So negative 1 multiply by Q multiply by R multiply by R and multiply by R. Okay, understand? Boleh faham ni? Okay, now. Okay, selesaikan nombor dahulu. 6 multiply by negative 1, what is the value? 6 multiply by negative 1. 6 darab negative 1. Tekan calculator juga ke? Negative 6. Okay, now you see how many P we have? 1, 2, 2. Okay, so P to the power of 2. How many Q we have? 3 and 4. So Q to the power of 4. And lastly, how many R?
3.
R to the power of 3. So this is the answer. Okay, negative 6 P square Q to the power of 4 and R cube. Okay, sama macam tadi juga. Kaedah yang kedua boleh buat apa? Okay, ambil coefficient dahulu. 6 multiply by negative 1. Okay, tulis kat sini. 6 multiply by negative 1. Okay, next. P to the power of 2 Q to the power of 3 multiply by Q R to the power of 3. Okay, now. So 6 multiply by negative 1? Negative 6. Okay, P ada berapa kat sini?
2.
So P to the power of 2. Q ada berapa?
4.
Here we have 3. Sini ada 3, sini ada 1 kan? So berapa Q?
4.
4. So Q to the power of 4 and R to the power of
3.
3. Understand? So now I want to ask you, which method you prefer to use? Yang pertama ke yang kedua?
Pertama.
Okay. Pertama mudah faham, tapi jalan kerja kena panjang lah sikit. Kena senarai satu-satu. Okay. Yang kedua, kalau yang faham yang kedua, boleh buat kaedah yang kedua.